I have something to tell you. I've been in therapy since March. On and off, and online therapy, that is. So I first found out about online therapy through a good friend of mine here on YouTube. I am Karen O, and she really loved it, so she recommended it to me. And I don't know if this is serendipity or manifestation at its core, but this app actually reached out to me and wanted to sponsor the AM with Amy. And as you guys know, I am such an advocate for mental health awareness, which is how the AM with Amy came to be, because I wanted people to feel better about themselves inside and out. So thank you so much to BetterHelp for sponsoring this video. And I just want you guys to know that seeking professional help is nothing to be ashamed of. And I think everyone can benefit from talking to a licensed professional. So if you don't know what BetterHelp is, BetterHelp is an online app that provides affordable private online counseling. You can get access to trained, licensed, fully accredited counselors and therapists. They're LGBTQ friendly. You can have them be religious, non-religious, and it's great for couples therapy, although I personally haven't done that option. In March, I was going through a lot, and as someone who travels a lot, I just found it more convenient to do online therapy, because I remember in March about to go on a flight in LAX, and I had my hour phone call with my therapist, and I was just in the airport talking about my problems. So it's been really convenient. But more than that, I think in-person therapy has always been really intimidating for me, and just financially, I don't think it's the smartest decision, because it can be quite expensive. And with BetterHelp, pricing is as low as $35 to $65 a week for unlimited access via text to a licensed professional, and you get a once a week video or phone call. I have personally not done the video phone call, although I'm open to it. It's as easy as signing up. All you have to do is go to betterhelp.com/amy and you fill out a questionnaire, and they just match you to a perfect counselor for you, and then you can get started with counseling. And if the match isn't right, you can just ask for a new one. I have switched my counselor once, so don't think that you have to constantly stick with the same counselor. So I hope you guys check it out. But for those of you who are not yet there to do some online therapy, I wanted to do the 5 books to help jumpstart your journey into self-help, self-development, spirituality, whatever you want to call it. You guys know that I'm such a huge, I love this stuff. I have nothing else to say. I love this stuff. The first book that I recommend to anyone starting their journey, well, these are just books for anyone, I believe, but for you specifically who's trying to start your journey into self-help, this is The Book of Awakening by Mark Nepo, Having the Life You Want by Being Present to the Life You Have. This is 365 daily nuggets of spiritual wisdom. It comes with daily meditations. This book is full of simple truths and stories for everyday lives. It's just given me so much enlightenment and wisdom on topics like jealousy, love at first sight, procrastination, and I find that this is the most helpful to read right as soon as you wake up or right before you go to sleep. I feel so much lighter after I read this, and this is one of my queen's favorite book. This is Oprah's, one of her favorite books. I also recommend this for those of you who haven't read a full book in a while, because it's just a paragraph a day, and it's great for those of you with a short attention span, like myself. The second book I recommend is The Power of Now by Eckhart Tolle. I love this book because it teaches the foundations of meditation in a sense, as it tells you how to detach from your past thoughts, your future thoughts, and how the only thing that exists is the now, and how to stay present, and how time traveling essentially brings us so much pain. This book can truly transform your thinking and how you think of your thoughts. That sounds very meta. I've mentioned this book in the AM with Amy a couple times, but most recently in How to Let Go of the Past. So I'm gonna leave that video up in the cards here or there. I don't really know where it is. So you can find out more about this book and hear excerpts from it in that AM with Amy. But this is just great for those of you who are having a lot of difficulty detaching from the past or your future thoughts. This is The Book of Joy by the Archbishop Desmond Tutu and His Holiness the Dalai Lama. And basically, their lives are coming to an end, to put it succinctly, but they spend a week together speaking about the 8 pillars of joy, and they have someone record it, and here it is in this book form. I'm constantly rereading this, and it differentiates joy from happiness, as joy is a level of contentment that you find in everyday life, and it's not overstimulating, it's not about indulging. It's about genuinely finding contentment in your everyday life and why so many people struggle with that. I have underlined and highlighted this book so many times, I cannot tell you. This book begins with the nature of true joy and then the obstacles, and then it goes into the 8 pillars of joy. It's fun to read because they have 2 different points of view on a lot of topics, and I think I personally side with His Holiness, the Dalai Lama. This is a book that I try to reread every so few months because I can forget about the 8 pillars of joy.
Do you need some self-help, Komi?
The 4th book I want to recommend, I actually don't have the physical copy with me. It's out on loan to a friend. Soy, if you're watching this, I want that back. But it is a self-help staple. This is one of the most well-known self-help books out there. This book has 6 ways to get people to like you and 9 ways to change people without arousing resentment. It is such direct and simple writing that I think genuinely anyone can read it and anyone can breeze through it really quickly. This is one of the giants in self-help. It is a timeless classic. It has been reprinted over and over the course of 3 or 4 decades, I believe. And if you're someone who is socially awkward like myself, and if you are someone who just wants to learn how to deal and interact with people more beneficially, I would highly recommend reading this book because it just allows you to foster better relationships with people and how to go about certain situations. I think one of the most helpful pieces of advice I got from that book is the sweetest sound in the world is the person's own name, because for a long time I was really bad at people's names and I'm still pretty bad at it, but it just tells you that learning people's name is so important in fostering a good relationship with them. And the last book I want to recommend is The Daily Stoic, and I talked about The Daily Stoic companion journal in one of my favorites videos, which I will also link up above in the cards here or there. I have it in my Kindle app on my phone because, again, it is 365 days of daily meditations and practical bits of wisdom. I just found out about this book through my brother, actually, and he reads it every single day. It's very similar to the Book of Awakening, except for the fact that the entire book is based on the philosophy of Stoicism, and it's the principles taught by Marcus Aurelius, Epictetus, and it is just about the art of living, and there are so many bits of practical wisdom, and it is great for any of you who are just looking for some clarity in life and learning how to stay still in such a busy, overstimulating environment. And I again try to read The Daily Stoic either before going to sleep or right before I start my day. I actually screenshotted and posted an excerpt from The Daily Stoic on my Instagram on Contemporary Notions of Beauty, and so many of you liked it. I'm gonna leave it shot up right here. If you like this excerpt, you should check out The Daily Stoic. But those are my 5 books on how to jumpstart your journey into self-help, self-development, spirituality, whatever you want to call it. I hope you guys enjoyed watching, and please check out BetterHelp with my link down below, betterhelp.com/Amy. And remember that when you sign up, you are also supporting this channel. And thank you so much for tuning in for the AM with Amy. I think I'm actually going to have the time slot be every Thursday, every other Thursday of the month, and have its own time slot because the AM with Amy is one of my favorite series. And I hope you guys enjoyed, and I hope you go read. I might do podcasts next because I love podcasts. Yeah, so hit that subscribe button if you like this video, and I will see you guys next one. Bye.